Do you have an event, a consulting session, something that you would like to offer for sale where people can book the call, pay for it up front, and then meet you over Zoom? Something like this. So I've got a Calendly setup review where we spend an hour looking through your Calendly events, how they are set up, what it's like for somebody who books a call with you, what's their experience. So somebody can book this call. They pick a time that will show them in their time zone. So they put in their details. You can ask questions ahead of time if you want to. They make the payment and schedule the event. So they book the event. You can get paid through Stripe or through PayPal. You can set up those accounts. And then you just connect with them over Zoom. They share their screen and away you go. You deliver your consulting session. Let me show you how this is done. So first of all, before you can connect Calendly and accept money through Calendly, you need to have at least a professional Calendly account. As you can see on the Calendly professional account, you can collect payments with Stripe and PayPal. And if you make even one sale a month at $140, that's certainly going to pay for your Calendly subscription. Now, you can go to the Calendly page and you'll find a link in the description to this video. And you can see what it is if you'll build monthly or if you want to pay 12 months in advance and get that saving there. So the next thing is if you don't have an account with either Stripe or PayPal, then you can set those up. Once again, I'll include the link to stripe.com or to PayPal. And you can set those up, which is a nice, easy way for people to pay you. And they don't have to have a Stripe account or a PayPal account in order to pay you. Now, the third thing you will need is a Zoom account. Now, you could use a free Zoom account. However, Zoom now has a limit of 40 minutes, even for one-on-one meetings. So you will probably want to pay for a Zoom Pro account. Once again, this will pay for itself once you make a sale or two. Now, you can set your currency here on the Zoom plans and pricing page, link in the description below, and you can set it to be billed monthly or billed annually. This is the pricing at the moment at the time of recording this video. Okay, so you go into your Calendly account and we go to integrations up here and we want to connect. First of all, we want to connect Zoom. And now a Zoom account administrator must pre-approve this in the Zoom marketplace. So if you're not the admin of your Zoom account, you'll need to speak to somebody who is. Okay, we'll go to the event types in a moment, but we want to go into manage integration. And actually that is already connected, so that's great. So the second thing we want to do is connect either Stripe or PayPal to Calendly. And this is going to allow you to charge for your session ahead of time so people can prepay. You just go connect with Stripe. And you don't need to use Zapier or something to connect these two. Just go connect with Stripe. And once again, you type in your Stripe email. I've got the verification code. Okay, so now we are connected. So now all we need to do is set up the event. And I'm going to set this up as a one-on-one event. You do have other options here depending on your Calendly. I'm going to make this very simple, a one-on-one event, and let others pick a time that suits them. So I'm going to call it review your Calendly setup. Now I'm going to add a location here. In this case, it's Zoom. I could add an alternate location such as Google Meet or Microsoft Teams, or maybe make it a phone call or even customize it. But I'm just going to leave it as Zoom. And then I'm going to put in some details here. Review your Calendly setup. Get to change the color as well. Now there's a lot more that you can put into an event. How long ahead of time can people book it? I'm going to say 14 days. I'm going to say the event goes for 60 minutes, but you can make it custom if you want to set it at a different time. And I can set my availability for this particular event, or I could make it for other events. This is going to be in my local time zone, but when people book the time in Calendly, it will look at their time zone. Do I want to add a little buffer time beforehand to help me prepare for the event, or afterwards so that I don't have back-to-back events? And I can add some extra rules for my availability if I'm going to be taking some time off or be available extra hours at a particular time. So I can add some invitee questions here, and they can be required questions or just optional ones already. Okay, and we can add all kinds of options here on the questions, but I'm not going to do that. And now the other thing I really like this is the, I'll save and close that, is that you can have some follow-up messages or workflows, such as sending text notifications, email reminders, just to reduce the no-shows. But if people have already paid you in advance, they're very likely to turn up on time. You can include some notifications and some cancellation policies if you want. There's a confirmation page, and that could be just saying, hey, congratulations, you have booked this consulting session with me. Here's what you need to prepare. Here's a free gift. Please check out this website. Please check out this article. This will help you to prepare for our call. And you could even add a custom link in there. And collect payments, we've seen that already. But we're going to put in here a payment, and I'm going to say accept it with Stripe. Notice that PayPal isn't an option because I've connected Stripe. I'm going to say how much it is that I'm going to charge, and I'll put in some payment terms if applicable. Save and close. And that's it, the event is on. All I need to do is share this live page. I don't need this month thing, I can, but there's no problem. Just need to share this live page. I can share that over email, over social media, and I share it and I just say, hey, book the time with me, pay ahead of time, here's what you're going to get, and let's get started. Now, final recap is that this uses Calendly and Stripe, or Calendly and PayPal, as well as Zoom. Now, you can do this without Zoom. You can use an alternative such as Google Meet, or Microsoft Teams, or whereby, or something else. So you've got plenty of options there. That it's always worthwhile getting somebody else actually to book the event with you. Make it $1, but just get them to book the event with you, just so that you get to see what the experience is for them to go right through the whole workflow. And now the other thing is that if you want to pause this, if you just no longer want to offer this service or you want to turn it off for a while, you can simply turn it off there. You can see that that has grayed out now. And so that means that that service will no longer be available until you switch it back on. If you do want to make a copy of an existing service, you can certainly do that using the clone button.